Democratic presidential hopeful Joe Biden said on a Zoom teleconference with donors that he would reverse course on Trump, President Trump's policies toward Israel. Now, this comes at a time when Israel is facing even greater threats from Iran and from its proxies. Here to talk about this is Congressman Ted Yoho, who represents the 3rd Congressional District of Florida. Congressman, welcome back to Washington Watch.
Hey, Tony. Thanks for having me on. I look forward to it.
Well, let's talk about this. What is Joe Biden wanting to reverse?
Well, I think the thing that the world can feel assured of, if Joe Biden wants to do it, we know not to do it, because virtually every policy he's had on foreign policy has been wrong. And, Robert Gates pointed this out very succinctly in his book called Duty. And so if Joe Biden wants to do it, you want to go the opposite. He's way off base on this.
You know, one of the things he's calling for is a two-state solution, pushing for that, saying that he would oppose any of the annexation that current Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu is pursuing, which was a part of the, you know, the peace plan that the president had negotiated with Israel. So, this looks like a total reversal of what we've been seeing in terms of building a stronger relationship with Israel.
It is. And for Joe Biden to say he's going to reverse that, he's got to show a difference between him and President Trump. Unfortunately, it's at the peril of Israel and even the Palestinians. He says that what President Trump has done has inflamed people, and it's broken the peace process. But, Tony, if we look over the last 30 years, there hasn't been a real good process there. And Joe Biden is way off on this, and he needs to stay out of foreign policy. Again, I would advise people to read Robert Gates's book, Duty, and find out how wrong he was on so many foreign policies.
Well, you mentioned the Palestinian Authority. Now, what the former vice president says is he'll restore diplomatic ties with the Palestinian Authority. And, of course, as we mentioned, push toward a two-state solution, as he is clearly opposed to the Prime Minister, Prime Minister Netanyahu's proposed West Bank annexation. But he also wants to restore funding to the Palestinian Authority, which has been a source of a lot of controversy because of what they are funding.
Sure, sure. And, you know, that's a great point. And I'm glad you brought that up, because when I came into Congress in 2013, I found out about we were giving funding to the Palestinian Authority, who was using that money to pay people that committed crimes against Israel, killed American citizens or killed Israeli citizens, and they got a stipend. And if they went to prison, their family got paid. And I think the average, if I remember right, was $3,400 a month, when the average income over there is less than $400 a month. And so we're subsidizing them, the Palestinians, to do terrorism, and that was something that we wanted that to get removed. And finally, it took President Trump was the only one that was able to do it. And Joe Biden wants to reestablish that. And so he wants to reestablish the American taxpayers going to the Palestinian Authority to do acts of terrorism, and they get rewarded for that. And if a person is in prison for, say, 5 or 10 years, when they get out, and this is where it's just insane, that time served in prison goes towards government retirement. In addition, they printed up elementary school books, and they equated children or Israelis with pigs. And just, it was terrible. And it was just very hateful stuff. And so Joe Biden wants to restore that. And again, he's just way off.
Yeah, in fact, an article just this past week from the Jerusalem Post talking about how the Palestinian Authority is hiding terrorist salaries from donor countries in its financial reports. This process of, as you say, pay to slay is still continuing. And
it is.
It's something that I actually, when I went to Israel a number of times, met with those in Israel who were watching the Palestinian Authority. Palestinian Watch is a great source for this. And they showed where, as you pointed out, not only going to textbooks that fuel this hatred, but also their children's programs. Like, you know, their Big Bird is right. Like Big Bomb. I mean, they just, it's about, they celebrate the attacking and the murder of innocent people.
They do. And so go back to Joe Biden, what he wants to do. He says we've alienated the Palestinian Authority. The Palestinian Authority is willing, they're allowed to come and negotiate with us anytime. And it really should be a decision between the people of Israel and the people of Palestinian. You know, everybody talks about a two-state solution. And if they can do that, we'll facilitate them any way we can. But for Joe Biden just to use politics and say, well, I'm going to reverse what President Trump does, he is clueless of what he's talking about. And, you know, hopefully he'll stay in his basement and won't be an issue.
You're listening to Washington Watch. I'm your host, Tony Perkins, Congressman Ted Yoho, my guest from Florida. Congressman, when you look at some of the positive or some of the policies that this administration has pursued in terms of moving the embassy, the U.S. embassy to Jerusalem, recognizing that as the capital, I mean, that has been huge. Now, you talked.
It has been.
We heard when that was going to happen, that there would be all of this turmoil, that there would be rioting and there would be people dying in the streets around the world. I mean, every move that the Trump administration has made in regards to Israel, it's the naysayers have said, oh, this is going to lead to greater conflict and war. And in fact, it's not. And what Joe Biden wants to do is reverse those types of things. Now, he did not say on the call yesterday he wants to reverse the embassy move. In fact, a couple of weeks ago, he has basically said he's not going to touch that. But many of the policies that have actually brought us closer to possibly a managed peace in the Middle East, he wants to undo.
Yeah, and just briefly on the Capitol in Jerusalem, I think the past five or six administrations said they were going to do that, but they never did it. President Trump was the only one with a backbone and a spine that was willing to do that. There's a thing, and you know it, you know, to remove a Band-Aid, the best thing is just to rip it off. In medicine, you know, we deal with horses, and they get these chronic ulcers in their eyes, and they become what we call an indolent ulcer. The only way that will heal is to turn it into an acute situation. You look at the Palestinian-Israeli peace process. You go back to Jimmy Carter and the policies of Henry Kissinger under Nixon. We have been dealing with this since 1948 when Israel became a state. Something has to change. The status quo does not work. And so, like that indolent ulcer, sometimes you have to have an acute change of direction to get people to pay attention and say, all right, let's solve this problem. And it ultimately will be the Palestinian people working with the Israeli people, find something that they can agree on. And I think this really wakes them up to say, you know what, it's not going to be the same old, same old. And, I'm just glad President Trump has done what he's done, and he's pulled that funding from the Palestinian Authority. That was pay to slay, like you said, and those policies need to end, and we will not support those with American taxpayers' dollars.
And to be clear on this, as I've traveled there, and I know you have as well, the Palestinian people and the Israeli people, the Jewish people, those that are living in the West Bank, they're actually working together. This is not a problem with the vast majority of the people. It's the leadership that's being propped up with this money. And that's what it's doing, is giving them the power to influence the people, whereas the president's policies, President Trump, is creating business opportunities and people to have jobs and not be dependent upon the Palestinian Authority.
You know, you're absolutely right. And if people were able to go over there and travel like you and I have, and they see the Palestinians working with the Jewish people, they don't have a problem with it. It's when you get governments involved and you get these small-minded people in government that their whole existence revolves around conflict to keep them in power. And we need to get rid of those people, not just over there, but in our country and every country where people are there to serve themselves or a party versus to serve a nation.
Very quickly, Congressman Yoho, I want to transition to another Middle East issue with Israel and the Hezbollah in Lebanon. Mm-hmm. The war drums are beginning to beat there as we're beginning to see some incursions there into Syria. We're seeing Hezbollah making threats. Are we possibly going to see something erupt over there soon?
There's definitely saber rattling, and I can only thank Iran for being the biggest supporter of Hezbollah. And let's hope that doesn't happen, that things can come to some kind of diplomatic truce. You know, you and I in our lifetime, we've seen so much conflict, and we've never seen a great world war, nor do we want one, and we don't want anything to be a flashpoint. Let's just hope calmer heads prevail. And, you know, I can only imagine that the underhand of Iran and the Ayatollahs, which we know are supporting Hezbollah, that's their biggest source, and it's a proxy group for Iran, they would love nothing more than to distract Israel and the United States to have another conflict somewhere to take the eyes off them.
Well, you're right. Let's hope that doesn't happen. Of course, the U.S. sanctions are probably the only thing keeping them in check right now after they had all of the spending spree from the Obama era and the nuclear deal that enabled Iran to fund those proxies. Congressman Ted Yoho, thanks so much for joining us today.
Tony, thank you. And I appreciate what you do. And take care. God bless.